This place was previously impossible to reach. Its accessibility has only been realized by the construction and launch of the Tsunza Viaduct along the Dongokundu Bypass Phase 3. Thanks to this breathtaking piece of engineering, lives have changed. A viaduct is a specific type of bridge made up of multiple small spans or arches, usually used to cross a large area of land like a valley or other low ground. The area we are currently in is a peninsula. A peninsula is a piece of land that is almost entirely surrounded by water but connected to the mainland on one side. Before this viaduct was launched in 2024, Tsunza area, which is a peninsula, was largely cut off because of the ocean. The only way to reach here was by boat, which was a dangerous mode of transport even during the low tides. During high tides, where we are currently standing is normally covered by oceanic waters, making it impassable. But how was this viaduct built? A simple look at the substructure brings your attention to the expansion gaps between the span girders. These gaps help the bridge expand or contract depending on temperature and vibrations caused by movement on the bridge. The bridge design also incorporates water outlets to prevent flooding. Water collected from the deck goes through these pipes into the ocean, allowing for quick removal of any water from the bridge when it floods. The outlets can be seen in many sections to assist in water removal. Another thing you can easily notice is, just like Mwache Bridge, this viaduct is also free from any wires, making it sleek and functional. The walkways or pedestrian pathways above are also fitted with strong railroads to prevent users from toppling over and falling into the ocean. From down here, you can quickly notice that this viaduct is built with reinforced concrete piers sunk deep below the waterbed to withstand both tidal waves during the high tide and the force of vehicles above. Its height was designed specifically to allow for the rise and fall of tides. This viaduct was built to work in harmony with the ocean. Engineers designed the viaduct to allow the natural movement of water, ensuring minimal disruption to the tidal flow. In the end, a road was built that respected the unique environment, making Tsunza special. The viaduct is majorly supported by the pier caps and the piers, with mainly bile caps under each pier to ensure that the bridge survives the test of time. 5 heavily built piers support the deck slab. When the Kenyan government, through the Kenya National Highways Authority, realized the struggle of the Tsunza Peninsula, they knew that this viaduct measuring 700 meters had to be built. This viaduct is one of the most ambitious infrastructural developments in the region and is also one of the longest viaducts in Kenya at the moment, towering over the waters that once isolated the Tsunza Peninsula. The viaduct acts as a second bridge in our Dongokundu Bridge series, connecting Mombasa County to Kwale County by road. This viaduct has become a towering monument, offering a lifeline between Mombasa and Kwale County. What was once a dangerous journey has now become a quick and easy drive. There is no more guessing when the tide will be low or dangerous boat ride. The viaduct has made a region that was once cut off from the rest of the world accessible to many. Building a bridge of this magnitude wasn't easy. One major hurdle was working around the mangrove forest and the local wildlife without causing irreversible damage. For every mangrove that was cut down to make this project a reality, 4 more mangrove trees were planted. The government managed to keep the environment intact. Not a single hectare of mangrove forest was lost during this project. While building this bridge, the government also helped the local community by building a couple of boreholes. providing books to nearby schools, building a police station to ensure the area is safe, as well as providing employment. This viaduct does not just enable people to get from Mombasa County to Kwale County. It has connected communities, created opportunities, and sets the stage for a better future. If you've made it this far to the second part of the series, you are definitely in for a treat. Our next video will reveal how the 1.4 kilometer long mteza bridge completes the circle of progress. Trust me, you don't want to miss that bridge, which is not only the last bridge in the Dongokundu Bypass Bridge series, but it is also the most impressive of the three bridges. To keep bringing you these incredible stories and showcasing Kenya in all its glory, I need your help. If you enjoyed this video, consider supporting the channel. Buy me a coffee, send a donation, or gift me through Super Thanks. Every bit helps us continue this journey together. We need all assistance we can get. Let's make sure no story goes untold. And remember, this is just the second of the three bridges of the Dongokundu Bypass, so subscribe, hit the notification bell, and stay tuned for the next adventure. Thanks for joining us on this incredible tour. If you found our video to be informative or entertaining, please support us by hitting that like, share, notification, follow, and subscribe button for more incredible adventures. Also share it with your friends and check out the other playlists for more exciting videos made just for you. Remember to join us for more incredible adventures. Until next time, keep exploring, keep discovering, and keep embracing the beauty of our world. Thanks for watching, and see you on the next adventure.